from the Professional Beauty team. I'm here at the Emmy Pearl Menopause panel event today, and I'm here with two experts in menopause, and we're just going to give you a very quick insight to menopause and how it affects the skin. So if you guys could just introduce yourselves, maybe Teresa, you can start first.
Hi everyone, I'm Teresa Tammy, and I'm a skincare expert based in London, Belgravia.
Hi, I'm Dr. Emma Wedgworth. I'm a consultant dermatologist on Harley Street.
So menopause is such a big issue, and I feel like this year particularly there's been a lot more of a spotlight on it. What are some of the biggest issues that menopause can cause in the skin?
So I think we start to see a lot of problems with loss of collagen, and that results in the skin looking a bit thinner, wrinkling. I think you lose that really nice sort of firmness that you tend to get. And we know that in the first 5 years of menopause, you lose about 30% of your collagen, which is massive. So that's one of the big issues that we see. And then we were talking about dryness as well.
Lots of dryness in the skin, going back to the loss of collagen, which would then be loss of elastin, loss of firmness, so a little bit more saggy, more fine lines, and that would come mainly from the dryness too, actually. The glow. Everyone wants the glow, so with the dryness you would lose, I guess, the glow of the skin.
And I guess as well, when you are premenopausal and postmenopausal, your skincare routine needs to change. And I think sometimes therapists are a little bit scared to recommend something different, and even treating clients during that time can be quite challenging, the flushes and sweats. How should they go about talking to their client about it, and are there any no-nos in terms of like ingredients to use for clients who've got menopausal symptoms?
So we're talking about the dryness, and I think actually you tend to get more sensitive over time. So our skin barrier, which is what controls our skin sensitivity, definitely gets a little bit more fragile. So you may find that you need to increase up hydration, that you may need to make things a little bit richer, but really trying to avoid things like oils, which actually can block pores at the sort of time where your hormones are going up and down, and that can be sort of quite a no-no for me.
Yeah. So, I mean, if we want to speak about the product and Emipel as a product, we've got lots of ingredients in there that will help the skin during menopause, but just the general skin condition. So you have retinol in there, which would obviously help the brightness of the skin without having too much in there if anyone's having any sensitivity from menopause. What I love about this brand is you have two products. I'm a massive fan of not layering products, not using too many, not getting the skin, over-treating the skin. So what I love is it has a serum, which is really nice to use morning and night. And then if anyone wants just that extra layer, you've got the cream to add to the evening, and if you want to do it in the morning too. So really simple routine, two products, which I'm a huge fan of.
And when it comes to treatments, are there any particular treatments that are good for menopausal clients, skin treatments, and are there any that are too aggressive or maybe too abrasive for somebody who's got sensitized skin?
Yeah, so I would say treatment-wise, everyone, people are different. Some people may not suffer from hot flushes, some people will suffer a lot from hot flushes. So I'm a massive fan of radio frequency. So radio frequency would be good for skin tightening, but with radio frequency comes heat. So I guess that depends on whether the client is suffering from the hot flushes and whether that would affect them. I would say things like microneedling, some really soft fractional just to help resurface and to really help brighten the skin, that really works well with products too.
I'd be a little bit careful about really deep scrubs and exfoliation. It's not I really don't like it very much, but actually being really careful about that because we know that will break down the skin barrier.
Yeah.
So those sorts of treatments, a lot of abrasive treatments, I'd be actually really careful about.
Yeah. And obviously both of you guys have been using Emipel, which is this new range which is targeted at women in the menopause. Why have you guys both decided to use it? What do you think the benefits of it are, and why other salons as far as skin clinics should look to take it on?
I think it's just a really intelligent sort of technology. So I think for years and years we've slightly ignored the hormonal changes that happen after menopause as dermatologists and haven't really sort of addressed them. And I think what Emipel does is that it's got this new technology, the MEP, which really tries to restore the effects of an estrogen-like effect on the skin and sort of try and reverse those hormonal changes that have happened and that can target the skin. So I think it's just a really intelligent, targeted way of trying to protect the skin against the sorts of problems that we see when estrogen levels start to drop and women start to approach menopause.
And going back to what Emma said about the MEP technology, it's the only product on the market that has been scientifically proven to actually mimic and help the skin from the estrogen levels, which obviously have an impact on the skin for the hydration and the anti-aging.
And I think the other thing is, for me, it's clinically proven, so we can see some really nice studies that have come out of the US which actually just show some really impressive results. And I think as a doctor, for example, I'm always about the clinically proven.